Russia considers itself rightfully to be among the great powers.
The great power, but a lonely great power.
I don't think it's one of the superpowers. It's definitely not close to the US in its ability to project power, and it doesn't have the economic muscle, and it doesn't have the global soft power. But it's definitely, if we're talking second tier of global players, because of its military size, because of its nuclear arsenal, because of its a pretty sizable economy still, and ability and resolve to project force and protect its interests.
This pivot itself means that Russia will only be integrated into the world as a whole, not into any part of the world, any combination, any association of various powers.
So I think that Russia is really trying to establish itself as an independent player to make big moves on this global chessboard on its own.
The Russian foreign policy priorities could be described as follows. Protecting one's turf, meaning largely the countries of the former Soviet Union, remaining security buffer zones for Russia, asserting itself as a global player, as a great power, recognized as such by the rest of the world, including the United States, standing up to the pressure now exerted by the US and its allies, and diversifying Russia's foreign policy to include so many other non-Western players as close partners, to compensate partially for the deterioration of relations with the West.
Still, you need ties with the outside world to get credit, to get investment, to get technology, and that's where China comes very much in play as an important partner for Russia.